Hello friends, in this video let's talk about one of the important easy concept, group by clause with having. What is group by? First of all, group by is the one which helps you to group the data based on particular column. So that column can be a product, can be a department, can be a location or whatever it is. I clearly talked about in my earlier video what exactly group by and how to use a group by, what is the advantage of the group by. But in this video I'll be talking about more on the group by with having. So group by is the one which helps you to group the data. When you have a similar data, it helps you to group it. So once group is done, you can calculate the sum, you can do the count, you can apply the aggregate operations. And then what is having here? First of all, having works only with group by. Having works only with group by. Group by and having we can have with where clause or whatever it is. Having works with only group by clause. Having is the one which helps you to restrict the data which is group by is giving. Let us say group by is giving 10 records. The capability of having here is which helps you to restrict the data, which helps you to filter the data which is provided by the group by clause. Let me show you practically how to use group by with having. Let me take you to the SQL Server Management Studio. So here I will be using some SQL Server 2016, but group by with having is very old concept. You can see in 2005, 2008, 2012, 14, 16 and so on. So let me take one basic table, select star from employee. See, if you see here, I have a employee table which contains around 5 columns with 22 records. So location, company, department and employee name and salary. Now I want the list of employees on location wise. So let me apply a group by clause and let me write it. Select from employee, group by, as I told you, I want the employee count based on the location. So let's take this location, comma, count of one or count of star, it doesn't make any difference to me. So alias name I am keeping as count of employees. So let me run this query. See, India contains 9 employees, UK contains 7 employees and USA contains 6 employees here. Now, so let me apply a having class. So let me write down a syntax first of all. Syntax. So group by and having clause works with the select queries. Select column names and so on from table name, group by, column 1. So at least once you feel that you have to use group by, then at least one column is mandatory. You can put how many columns you want, but the other columns are second column onwards is optional. If you have requirement, use it, otherwise leave that. Having is also optional only. If you have a requirement, use it. Having condition. So if you are using having, then you should use the condition. So this is a syntax of group by with having. So here if you see this, I have used only till group by. So now having. So now what is the requirement I have here? So here I have very less number of records. So I have India, UK and USA. Okay, so now I want the list of locations which contains more than 7 employees. 7 are more than 7. So I want the list of countries which contains more than or equal to. Equal to 7 employees. So then how to write it? So let me write the same query. Let me achieve that results. Here I am showing you with the basic query. So later I will show you the complex query with joins. Group by having with joins. So let me write with a single table query. So employee group by location having count of 1 greater than or equal to, I made it as here, more than or equal to 7. Okay, so now here let me make it as a location here, comma, count of 1. If you see this query, let me make it bigger, see here. Here I got only 2 records. So if you see the earlier query, so let me remove all these. Let me make it a comment. Hope you know that the comment. You can use 2 hyphens to comment this one. Let me remove the syntax to run all the queries in one shot. Let me remove this original query, which I don't need. Now let's run this. The first query gives you the 3 records, India 9, UK 7, USA 6. The second query gives only India and UK. So why? Because second query having a having clause which is restricting the result of the group by clause. So how it is restricting? If the count is, if the number of employees is more than 7, then only it displays, otherwise it doesn't display in your results. So this is how you write group by with having. As I told you, having we can use only with group by. Without group by, I cannot use having clause in the SQL queries. Now let me show you group by having clause with joins. So let me take you one big example here, which I have in AdventureWorks 2016. I have a sales table where it contains around more than 100,000 records. So if you see the number of records in a particular table, I have around 121,000 records almost. So 121,317 records I have. So if you see here, I have a sales order ID, tracking number and order quantity, product ID and special offer ID and so on. So now I want the sales based on the product. How many products has been sold? I want to identify that. And a product wise, how many products? Let us say, let's take a product 776. How many items has been sold? Maybe 1000 or 2000, something like that. Now 777, 771 and so on. But I cannot understand the numbers. I need a name of the product. So let's take a textiles. Against the textiles, I need a count of the how many textiles has been sold. Let's take a helmets. How many helmets has been sold? Let's say 1000, 2000, 5000 and so on. So here I do not have a product name here. I need to join with a product table to get it. So let me join with a product table. Then I will apply a group by. Then I will apply a having class. So let me write down. Here I already have a table ready. So I got it from AdventureWorks. So I'm going to make it as SOD as a alias name. Join production. It's a schema dot product p. So on p dot product id equal to sod dot product id. Okay, so now what are all the columns you need? I need p dot name, comma, count of 1. So I am going to make it as a product count. Okay, so if I run this as it is query, it fails. Why? Because the query does not contain aggregate function or the group by class. So now let's run, apply the group by class, group by p dot name. Now let's run this. This gives you the product name against the list of the count. Let us say sport helmet, red, black, and so on. You can see this. You have this multiple. So road bikes, mountain bikes, and so on. You have around 266 records we have. So this is how we apply group by class. Now the requirement is, I want the list of product which is having the cell count as more than 1000. I want to identify the list of product which has been sold more than 1000. So now let's put like this, having count of 1 greater than or equal to 1000. So now I'll be getting the list of products who has 1000 product count. Let's run this. Now I have only 27 records. So earlier, if you remember, I got around 266 records, but I got only 27. Why? Because so these are all the list of products which has been sold more than 1000 numbers. So you can see ML mountain tire, HL mountain tire, LL road tire, and so on. So if you want to see like around 3000, you want to identify the list of products which has been sold more than 3000 items. Execute it. Now you have this. See, this is how you apply the having class to restrict the results. If you do not apply any having class, you will get all the results. You will get all the results. Around 266 records you have it. See, if you understand clearly, where clause also restrict the records, here having clause also restricting the records. But where clause I can directly write on the select query, but having class I can write only with the help of the group by only. Having class I cannot write without group by, but group by I can write without having. In the group by class, having is optional, but in the having class, group by is essential for me. So this is how we do apply group by and having classes. Lastly, having class is the one which helps us to restrict the records which is generating by the group by. So that's all about group by with having class. So if you have any questions in MS BI, Azure, Power BI, or SQL Server, you can drop your question in the comment section. I'll try to answer as soon as possible. So even it can be an interview question, it can be a general question. So also follow me on Facebook for more technical updates. You have my Facebook link on the screen. You can just go to the link to follow it. So that's all about this today's. So let's meet up in the next video. Please like and subscribe for more technical videos. Thank you.